Hello, everyone. We're here in District 2 at Felly's Gallery, and we're here with Miss Ayers, who did a fantastic job with the Juneteenth. Miss Ayers, what brought you to bring this to District 2 and to bring this forward?
Actually, reading during the pandemic, I had learned about a group of women, the Housewives League of Detroit, and they were very, very innovative and supportive people. And what they did was they supported black businesses, patronized black professionals, and bought black products. And they were able to generate 75,000 new jobs during the Great Depression. So learning about these women inspired me, because I'm like, if they did this at a time when it was not even technology or anything to like really get the word out, and they made that much of an impact, I was just thinking, what can we do? So I brought the idea to the committee and to your office, and that's how everything got started. Oh, and to Felly, Dolphin, and Rev Ron, so.
Here we are.
Just pitched it, yep, and here we are.
And then with Felly, he just took over the idea and made this beautiful mural. Yeah. Brother Felly, what caused you to bring this mural forward?
Well, I mean, with Juneteenth and with the event going on, and the 50th anniversary of the Marvin Gaye, the changing of the street name, I just thought, you know, just mixing in the music and, you know, us, we need that music in our veins, and me being an artist, I had to definitely incorporate my love for the Motown sound and my love for Marvin Gaye's music. So the incorporation of, like I said, what's going on and the Juneteenth Jubilee, it just made all the sense in the world.
And you know, this was a collaborative effort on all three of our parts, as well as the community, as well as the administration. And I can't thank them enough. And when you look at this, you talk about, well, you also talked about the 50 years.
Yeah.
What happened? I mean, elaborate on that, brother.
Well, I mean, you know, beyond 50 years, but you know, Marvin Gaye said it best 50 years ago, what's going on. And like you said, we're still fighting this fight today, and we're still struggling, and a lot of us, you know, it's still hard. Mm-hmm. So like I said, Marvin spoke on it, and we're just still fighting the fight. And, you know, thank God they just, you know, finally decided to make Juneteenth a national holiday. You know, a little late, but, you know, we're here, and we're making it happen. So, like I say, you know, Marvin said it best, and we're going to keep on pushing it and keep on promoting what Marvin talked about 50 years ago.
And Ms. Ayers, you know, with the upcoming generation and you leading it, how does this come with you, ma'am?
Well, I mean, overall, I just think it's important to be an example of what we want to see.
Yes.
Yeah.
So with that, if we want to continue to celebrate our heritage and our people, and we have a predominantly black city, we have to start something.
Yes.
And that's the biggest thing. Like, if we start it, then we can pass the torch.
Yes. Not so,
beautifully said.
Yes.
Thank you.
Excellently. Not only to start it, but to continue on, because it is the generations that's coming behind each of us.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
That we want to make sure that this continues on and it never stops. Juneteenth today is the first anniversary, first federal holiday that it's going to be, and we want it 50 years from now.
Oh yeah, oh yeah, oh yeah.
50 years from now.
So what made you guys want to buy into the idea?
Because
it makes sense.
It made sense.
I mean,
yeah.
it was a lay down. It was nothing to think about.
Okay. Yeah.
It was like, let's make it happen.
Yes, yes.
You were supportive. No,
so I just want to thank you so much. Thank you both so much for being involved. And I want to thank the community, District 2, and the City of Detroit for making this happen. Thank you so much, and God bless you.